In today's video, we are going to be talking about shrimp, specifically the top 7 easiest aquarium shrimp that are great for beginners and are hardy. Starting off with shrimp number 7, we've got the ghost shrimp. These are very common aquarium shrimp. You're gonna see them in basically all the big chain stores like Petco and PetSmart. Not as much in these mom and pop stores or these smaller stores. I don't know why, maybe it has to do with retail or something, but these shrimp are very common, very popular. A lot of beginners keep them. Thing that everyone knows about these guys is that they cost very, very little. In some places you could get 10 for like $1 or $2, sometimes even less amount of money. Usually in Petco's or the chain stores around where I live, they cost about $1 each, which is actually pretty expensive compared to a lot of other stores. They used to be 50 cents each, but they raised the price for some reason. But these shrimp are incredibly hardy, very strong. The reason they don't cost as much is because ghost shrimp are normally used as feeder shrimp, which means that they're typically bought for the purpose of feeding them to large fish or like monster fish. And that's why in some areas they're so cheap. It's because they're used as feeders, and so people just buy them and just feed them to their fish or even turtles. They're also known as glass shrimp, which you can see by their appearance, which is transparent and see-through. These shrimp do not live very long. They usually only live up to a year at max. So you might want to keep that in mind if you're thinking about getting these guys. But they are considered easy to breed. A lot of people breed these shrimp, so they're able to get a lot of offspring to compensate for the short lifespan. Moving on, number 6, we have the yellow Neocaridina shrimp. These shrimp have got quite a unique color, which is this bright yellow gold. Just like their other Neocaridina counterparts, the females tend to possess a lot more vibrant color as compared with males. The thing cool about their color is that yellow is a pretty unique color for shrimp. Most shrimp you're gonna find are not gonna be this yellow goldish color, which makes these shrimp very unique from the others. They may seem very advanced and difficult to keep, but they're very easy to care for. Great beginner shrimp, yellow Neocaridinas are gonna eat the biofilm and algae in your tank, and their color especially is great for planet tanks. Coming in at number 5 on the list, we have the snowball shrimp. This is another type of Neocaridina, just like the yellow Neocaridina shrimp. But snowball shrimp are purely white or translucent in color, so you could look at them, you could see right through them, kind of similar to the color of ghost shrimp, kind of not. Snowball shrimp have like a filled, milky look, while ghost shrimp look more transparent. But the color in snowball shrimp was achieved by years of breeding by experts, which is one of the reasons why they are so popular. This type of shrimp is one of those that don't have a grading scale, because their breeding has been mainly consistent throughout the years, and what that means is that chances are the snowball shrimp you get are all gonna have the same pure white look with very little mutations. So unlike many shrimp varieties you see that are graded based on how good of a quality they look, snowball shrimp are very rarely graded. They've been bred in a way that their genetics is basically pure snowball shrimp. And most of these shrimp you get at the fish store are gonna be the same quality, which is very much true in my experience. These shrimp are incredibly hardy, another type of Neocaridina. Number 4 on the list, we have the bamboo shrimp. Bamboo shrimp are found in freshwater streams and rivers. These shrimp are known as what you call filter feeders, which basically means they're great at catching debris that's flying around in fast flowing water. In my opinion, they've got quite a unique look, very much camouflaged with their environment, kind of like a bamboo in fact. But they are well camouflaged, presumably due to predators. Despite their appearances, bamboo shrimp are not aggressive. They're pretty peaceful and could be kept with other nanofish. Now, these shrimp come in many color varieties such as brown, red, and blue. I've only ever seen the brown ones. I haven't seen any other color varieties in local fish stores. But bamboo shrimp will need at least 20 gallons of water. Now, the reason for that is that they will grow up to 6 inches, which is very shocking to many. A lot of people assume they stay small like at the store, where they're typically around 1 to 3 inches. That's just size when they're normally sold, but they could get pretty big once they're fully grown. Make sure to keep that in mind. They're very beginner friendly and can tolerate a pH of up to 8.0. Next up at number 3 is the Amano shrimp. Amano shrimp were among the first shrimp I ever kept. They look kind of similar to ghost shrimp, kind of not. A lot of people get them confused due to their similar appearances. Amano, snowball shrimp, ghost shrimp, a lot of people can't tell them apart. But sometimes not even the employees at the local chain stores. These shrimp are different from ghost shrimp in that they, first of all, live much longer. I've had an Amano shrimp live to around 5 years. Some people even got Amanos that lived up to 10 years. They also look somewhat stronger than ghost shrimp. I don't know if that's just me or if it's reality. But I do think they look more robust, more healthy, and I think they're a great long-term algae eater. The only negative I could think of is these guys are somewhat sensitive to fluctuating water parameters. At least that's what some people said. In my experience, they're pretty much unaffected by water changes. But something to note is that the Amano shrimp can climb out of the fish tank. These guys are even known for climbing out of the tank. That's why a lot of people include a lid to prevent them from jumping out. Again, I haven't experienced this before, just something to be aware of. And they also eat black beard algae, which is another rare thing amongst shrimp. Most shrimp, or even fish, they only eat green spot algae or some other algae types. But yeah, Amano shrimp, great long-term shrimp, great algae eaters, definitely more popular amongst aquascapers or advanced fish keepers, but they're also great beginner shrimp, and is certainly one that I'd recommend trying. Down to number 2, we've got the blue dream shrimp. This is yet another Neocaridina type. These shrimp are characterized by their beautiful blue colors. I really like it, a lot of people do. These shrimp are tolerant to many water parameters and could usually be kept in tank sizes of 5 to 10 gallons because they usually stay pretty small. Something you might want to know is that the color on these shrimp will sometimes fade after multiple generations. This is because a lot of substrate like sand is light, and shrimp in general will usually tend to match the color of the substrate to better blend in. This is very true with blue dream shrimp. You want to keep them in a dark substrate if you want them to maintain their dark blue colors. But these guys are excellent scavengers. They're gonna go all over the tank looking for leftover foods, debris, and their dark blue color makes them a top choice for any fish keeper. And now finally at the top of the list at number 1, we have the red cherry shrimp. Cherry shrimp are the easiest shrimp of all time. They're incredibly hardy, very easy to keep, great beginner shrimp. Cherry shrimp are another Neocaridina type, just like the blue dream and snowball and yellow Neocaridinas. Cherry shrimp have that bright red color, which I absolutely love, and you probably will too. These guys are actually graded based on their color intensity, so a brightly colored cherry shrimp is going to be considered much higher grade than one that is lightly red. The highest intensity red color is the fire red variety, which is absolutely darkest red. These shrimp are going to look really awesome in a planted tank. Well, all of these shrimp on my list will, but cherry shrimp will certainly not disappoint. Cherry shrimp are probably the easiest shrimp to breed on this list as well. They're very prolific breeders, and so for all those reasons and many more, cherry shrimp are the number one best aquarium shrimp for beginners on my list. Thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe down below. We also have a fish keeping Discord server where we chat about stuff related to the aquarium hobby. Link to that is in the comments. Thank you for the support, and I'll see you all in the next one.